Hello, Professor Baekenshong. I'm Rachel. I'm just starting my research postgraduate study here at HKU and heard about research data management. What is it?
Hi, Rachel. First, you need to know what we mean by research data. Research data is data that is collected or created for the purposes of analysis to produce original research results. They can be facts, numbers, letters, symbols, images, videos, or samples recorded in print or digital format. Most likely as part of your thesis, you will create, collect, or license data for your research. That is your research data.
Okay, I think I understand research data. What about research data management?
As the name implies, it refers to how you organize, store, and care for your research data in a research project. In most cases, you need to create a data management plan on how you're going to carry out these activities. You would describe what data you will collect for your research project, how you're going to store and manage the data when you're working on the project, and how you're going to handle the data after the project is finished. The nature of your research project, data to be collected, and the requirements you need to fulfill will determine how you write your data management plan.
Now I understand the terminologies. Why is research data management necessary?
The short answer is because Hong Kong U requires it. The 2015 policy on the management of research records stipulates that researchers are responsible for developing and documenting clear procedures for the collection, storage, use, reuse, access, and retention or destruction of the research data and records associated with their research. But the deeper question is why Hong Kong U requires it. The primary reason is because it protects both Hong Kong U and the researcher if questions are raised later about the integrity of the research, such as whether the data were fabricated or falsified. The data management plan and the data together provide evidence about how and when the data were created or collected, including other relevant documentation.
So research data management is a university requirement. Does it bring other benefits?
Good research data management brings a number of benefits to researchers, including protection against data loss. By sharing your data, which is encouraged by the Research Grants Council, you can make your research outputs more visible and enable collaboration.
Sounds good to me. But who should be responsible for RDM?
The research postgraduate students themselves and their supervisors share the responsibility. For students admitted on or after September 2017, they are required to submit a data management plan or provide justification if a data management plan is not needed. This is part of the candidature approval process. They should consult their supervisors when making decisions on data management plans. And where appropriate, supervisors will be asked to approve students' decisions. In some cases, besides the data management plan, students also have to submit their research data to the online form. Those who want to make their data publicly available should consult their supervisors on the licensing and ethical issues.
Great, I know my role now. So when should I make a decision on DMP and research data?
Students have to make decision on their data management plan to have their candidature confirmed. In other words, a decision has to be made before the end of their probationary period. If a data management plan is necessary, students need to attach it along with their detailed scheme of research for their candidature confirmation. For research data, where applicable, students should upload their data to the online form when they submit their draft thesis for examination.
You mentioned the online form several times. What is it, and how should I fulfill the requirement?
The library has created an online form for research postgraduate students to make a decision on data management plans. Students will also use this form to submit their data management plan and their research data.
The process sounds fine to me, as I will be collecting my own data for my thesis, but what about students working on purely theoretical research?
That's a good question. Although we have been discussing data management plans and research data, there are some situations where they are not necessary. These include cases where no data will be collected or created, or alternatively, that the data is freely available on the internet or in the library. This exemption also applies to students using someone else's data or purchased data where the license forbids deposit.
Right, so in those cases, students do not need to do anything?
Not really. Although they do not have to submit data management plans nor research data, they still need to log on to the online form and provide relevant details. I suggest you visit the library's webpage on research data management instructions for research postgraduates. That page lists out all relevant policies and procedures, so you will know exactly what is expected.
Great! I definitely check out the page. Apart from that, where can I get more information?
The library has created a designated website on research data services. You will find plenty of information about research data management, including templates and tools, good practices, and frequently answered questions. You will also find training videos about the online form, like this one. The videos will take you through the process on data management and research data submissions. And of course, you will find information as to whom you can contact for advice.
Thanks a lot, Professor. I really need to do some research about research data management.
You're welcome. Good luck with your research.